What's going on? It's Big Rome. Today, what a day. So today I'm going to try out some new seasoning today. I'm going to go ahead and show you exactly what I'm going to be using. Check it out. We got Young Bucks steak seasoning here that I'll be using. The next thing I'll be using is Young Bucks. And this is actually a pulled pork seasoning that I got here to go ahead and try out. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to try it on some ribeye chops. How about that? Let's make that happen. Right, so first things first, let's go ahead and put a base on these ribeye chops. Take a look at them. Wow, aren't they beautiful? Man, I got these actually at Sam's Club. They're at $1.65 a pound. So on this, it was under $5 on these chops. Look at the thickness on these. Man, that's some good chop right there. So let's go ahead and add that base. So first things first, I'm gonna go ahead and use my Frenchie's brown sugar, yellow mustard here as a base on both. Once I go ahead and do that, I'm gonna go ahead and rub them. Make sure that brown sugar mustard is all over. Check that out. Man, it's looking good right here already. Just looking at that brown sugar, that mustard, all in there. And today I'm actually gonna be using my Weber propane grill today because weather is a little muggy, so I definitely don't wanna be out there in the rain when using charcoal, but it's gonna do the job. It's gonna do the job. So let's go ahead and make this happen here. So first one, let me go ahead and use the Young Buck steak seasoning. Let's go ahead and use it on here. Oh yeah, check that out. Let's go ahead and turn that around. It's looking good already. I'm gonna go all over on this steak, that's for sure. So let's see here. You hear my birds? I got about 8-9 birds out here. And you know, they're my daughters. So definitely, if you hear that in the background, that's what you're hearing right now. So. All right, I got the base on that one. So you wanna go ahead and take a look? Man, that's looking good right there. Check that out. It's all in there too. All right, next one we're gonna go ahead and do is the pulled pork seasoning here that we have. So let's go ahead and get that started. This one has more of a sweet base to it. So I wanted to try both of them out and see what it's all about, you know? Might as well take that opportunity. Ahead and pat it down. Do the same thing here on the side. Make sure all the areas of the chop is covered because that's exactly what we want to do. Oh yeah, this is looking good already. So this one has a little bit more of a sugar base to it. That's why they use it for the pulled pork, but I might as well try it on the chop and see what happens. Oh yeah, that's looking good right there. All right. So now under the steak seasonings that you can see here, there's a little bit more of a salty base to it. So I wanted to go ahead and see what it's all about too. So that's why I'm bringing it up, but look, check that out. Oh yeah, that's looking good right there. Man, let's go ahead and get started. Oh yeah. All right, so let's go ahead and get these steaks, ribeye chopped steaks, I would say, right in there. Take a look at the color. Oh my goodness, it's looking good right there. Oh yeah, let's go ahead and put these in here. First thing I'm gonna go ahead and do is I'm gonna go ahead and sear them, because that's exactly what I wanna do. I wanna sear them for 2 minutes, and then I'm gonna move it to the right a little bit and then sear them again. So we're gonna go ahead and close this off and see what happens. All right, let's go ahead and take a look. Oh yeah, look at that, looking good. Let's go ahead and flip these over. Oh yeah, we got some good sear marks here. Be some good chops right there. It's gonna be 2 minutes, rotate 2 minutes, and then right, let's go ahead and open it up. Oh yeah, check that out, that's looking good right there. Wow, looking beautiful right there. We got go ahead and got the steaks done. Let's go ahead and check the internal temp. 126, 133. No, it's time to pull them out. Oh yeah, 136. Let's go. All right, so let's go ahead and get these chops in here, wrap it on an aluminum foil, and let them rest for about 20 to 30 minutes. Oh yeah. All right, so now we had them all wrapped in aluminum foil. Now we're gonna go ahead and give it a cut and try it out. Let's go ahead and do this now. So as you can see, I got both chops here. I'm gonna go ahead and check it out and see what it's all about right here. Oh my goodness, check that out. That's looking good right there. Gonna have to try it, test it out. This is actually the pulled pork seasoning there. And then, oh yeah, that is the steak seasoning right there. Check it out. So in order to find out how good it is, let me go ahead and try it out myself, right? So let's go ahead and do that. Here we go. Pulled pork seasoning. Really good. I like it. I like it. Now let's try that steak rub. Man, it says to use it on steak, but man, it's good on chicken too. So, some good stuff right here. You gotta check them out. Big Rome out.